After consulting with business experts, administrators configure insights to define the insights that planners see on the insights display. Define insights for as many data intersections as you need. Planners see insights only for slices of data to which they have access. When configuring insights, keep the following in mind. Insights are configured for the most important data you want your planners to explore, especially to identify anomalies and bias. For the accounts or slices of data you are creating insights for, set thresholds based on their materiality. Consider whether there is volatility for certain slices of data. Identify the slices of data where your historical forecasts are stored to compare them and determine if there is bias. Expect to test the precision of the insights you configured and make adjustments. Let's configure insights to analyze revenue data. There are three different types of insights. Forecast variance and bias insights reveal hidden bias in forecasts submitted by planners by analyzing historical forecasts and actual data. This type of insight measures the variance or bias between two historical scenarios, such as forecasts and actuals. Prediction insights review where variances are greatest between future forecasts compared with machine predictions. For prediction insights, you need prediction data generated for future time periods. If prediction data is not available, then keep the default selection of No to automatically select Auto-Predict. Ensure that Auto-Predict is set up to generate predictions. You can bring in machine learning predictions or other predicted data to use for prediction insights. Anomaly insights detect unusual patterns in data. This type of insight detects outlier values that vary widely from other values. For example, a sudden volatility in actuals due to an external or internal event. Specify the slice definitions for analysis. For historical data, select the cube and indicate the number of historical years for which there is data. Define the actual and forecast POV for the data. You define slices for both historical and future data, which is then used by all three types of insights. For future data, select the cube and define the slice of data for the future data, both the forecast provided by planners and the base prediction, most likely a scenario. You can add a definition for the slice of data for the best case and worst case scenarios. Define the periods of future data to include in the analysis. Prediction results are stored in this location when you select Auto Predict. Define the thresholds to be considered for generating insights. For forecast variance and bias insights, select an error tolerance percentage, which defines the percentage variance between historical forecasts submitted by planners and actuals that lies within an acceptable range. In this example, any difference of 5% or above between historical forecasts and historical actuals is considered a significant variance and triggers an insight. For prediction insights, select a threshold percentage, which defines the acceptable percentage variance between future forecasts submitted by planners and computer-generated predictions. For anomaly insights, select a threshold which defines the acceptable threshold for z-score value, the standard deviation from the mean of the values. Anything that is too far from zero is typically considered an outlier. You can select or modify the metric and threshold for deviation on the Advanced Options page. Several metrics are available. See explanations for all the metrics in the online help, including the selected one. On the Settings page, you define how to display the insights to planners. For display dimensions, select the dimensions that planners will use to navigate and analyze the insights. The selected dimensions display on the Insights page. For impact magnitude thresholds, you define the low and high thresholds. When insights are displayed on the Insights page, this setting categorizes insights into high, medium, and low groups based on the percentage impact calculated for each insight. This helps focus attention on the insights that have more extreme variations. After configuring insights, you can run them at any time. You run insights from the Configure page. You can also set up a job to run insights at regular intervals, for example, when you have a new set of actuals. When you run an insight, Insights analyzes the data at each available intersection and looks for patterns and anomalies. For information about scheduling Insights jobs, review the Scheduling Jobs topic in the Configuring IPM chapter of the Planning Administrator's Guide. Configuring Insights is easy to do with the help of the Guided Wizard. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.